Okoko bioko. They say when you point one hand at someone, you have the remaining four pointing back at you. If you know, you know. A madman of reputable character. A madman that everybody know in Ile-Ife. They say the madman usually come to the palace because you know Kabiesi. Kabiesi is a spiritual human being. So the madman will always come and Kabiesi will give the madman food because that is what he does. Kabiesi is actually a very, very good man. So they say this madman entered the palace, but nobody saw him when he entered. But when Marian came back from the hospital, that if you see the brace that the madman pursued Marian, that everybody there were shocked, like, do you know her before? Did she do something to you? Because they've never seen that kind of pursuit. That the madman was shouting, what are you still doing here? What are you still doing here? Pack and go. Pack and go. At this point, my brothers, my sisters, we are free to let you guys know that Olori Mariam is no longer safe. Yes, Olori Mariam is no longer safe. Yes, so my correct people, the madman was not just shouting on Mariam, that the madman carry a wood, a firewood that is roughly rough, it's not smooth, that she said she will use it and send Mariam to Kogi. That was when everybody was shocked. Yes, so that the madman said that Mariam need to go back to Kogi. That since Kabiesi does not want to teach her a lesson, that him is going to teach Mariam a lesson. That why is it that Mariam want to scatter the palace? No be sumo matter. Yes, so that the madman said that if Mariam did not go, that they are going to pack Mariam's pieces. Everybody were now shocked. Like, is this a personal beef? Is this a personal beef? Because they don't even understand where it's coming from. You know, if you understand where something is coming from, you will know where to fight it. But this one, they don't understand where it's coming from. And people that have witnessed this madman, they have come out to say that this is not the first man this madman is saying this. Or neither, this is not the first time this madman is doing this. That the madman has always been coming to the palace. And anytime the madman comes to the palace, the madman will be telling Kabiesi so many things. That the madman will be telling Kabiesi, is this the woman you are calling your wife? This woman will bring you down. This woman hold your kidney in his hand. This woman hold your destiny in his hand. So people said this is not the first time. So for the madman to come this time around, this is like, okay, he finally come physically to say that thing he has finally been saying. He has finally come physically to see that thing he comes to say come to pass. But now people are shocked. People are shocked. People are saying, Kabiesi, if a madman can come and be saying this kind of thing, what other answer do you need? What other answer do you need for you to do the needful? A madman that they say his head is kolo, he does not know anything. But the madman is seeing more than everybody. My brothers, my sisters, it's not a small shoe baby. It's not a small thing, but I fly. Right now, they say what Mariam is saying that is annoying everybody is that Mariam is saying is somebody that sent the madman. Is somebody that pushed the madman to her. Why must you think that somebody pushed a madman to you? Why will somebody even have the time? You think it's everybody that have time like you to go and be pushing a madman to come and do you things or to come and say what the madman has always wanted to say? Ha! Now, wow! They say people are so embarrassed in the palace right now. They are embarrassed on behalf of Mariam. They are embarrassed on behalf of Kabiesi. They are embarrassed up to the extent that they don't even know what to talk. Why? Kabiesi, why? And Mariam, why? So Kabiesi, if a madman should tell you all this kind of thing, is it not high time for you to take redress? Like I say, and I will continue to say, are you sure these people are not using means on Kabiesi? Are you people sure they are not using means on Kabiesi? Because if you look at it, they say someone they use cognomi for, the person will not know that they use cognomi for he or she. So they might use cognomi for Kabiesi, and Kabiesi do not know that he has been cognomirized. He will not know that they've cognomi his destiny. Yes, now. Yes, so that the madman was shouting. that Miriam is not suitable to be in the palace. That Miriam is not suitable to be in the palace. Some people were not like, what is your problem? Are you the one that marry her? Are you the one that... The madman said, no, but they say at a point that is the elders that were not trying to hold or on the madman. They were not trying. He said, no, that he doesn't want to see this face. That this face does not deserve to be where human beings are. It was when he made that statement, people were shocked. People were shocked that this is not an ordinary madman. No. The madman said, every time they will be complaining there's problem in the palace. Every time they will be complaining there's chaos in the palace. Every time they will be complaining there's wahala in the palace. Have they ever sat down to ask themselves, they don't know that it's Miriam that is bringing the blackness. They don't know that it's Miriam that is bringing the chaos. They don't know that it's Miriam that wants to bring the palace down. And that he will not sit here and watch the palace go down. He will not sit, he will not take it at all, at all. When I heard this particular matter, I said, okay. Since the living don't want to, since the ones that have head don't want to fight, let the ones that have cause come and be fighting the fight. If you know, you know. My brothers, my sister, it's not a small matter. It's not a small shoot bed, mama fly you. That the madman is saying that, why are they not seeing? Why can't their eyes open? To know that this lady came to scatter the peaceful home. She came to scatter Yoruba nation with her yellow face. That what is her motive? What? Kilo gold, luto chilo shele, gong gong gong. What is her motive? Ah, that they were trying to beg the madman. They don't even know where to start from. Because at a point, it now looked like this is a personal vendetta. That the madman was not saying that is this woman, she is the number one person on the list that don't want Naomi to come back to the palace. She is the one that don't want that woman that used to pray with me, that woman that used to dash me money, that woman that used to give me food, that woman that used to tell me, you are clean today, oh, you are neat. Hey, that's why I tell people, you see all these mad people, it's not all of them, they are mad though. Some of them have things going on in their life. Look at how the madman is singing the praises of Naomi, even when Naomi is not around. Singing Naomi's praises and said, Miriam is black at heart. That the day they will see Miriam's heart, that all of them will run away. That he has seen Miriam's heart. That Miriam's heart is so black and black and black. That Miriam should carry her heart far away from Naomi. That Miriam should not try it though. That this second coming of Naomi, that anybody that try it, that the person will collect woto woto on a kum kum. When I heard this particular one, I said, come on, come on. The madman said that Miriam has done so many things, that she has done the undoable, that if they think he is lying, that Miriam should come and challenge him. That he's going to open Miriam's file like this. He's going to open Miriam's folder. That is Miriam that want to separate Kabiesi and Naomi. That Kabiesi's heart, he already wants now, and Miriam gone. Yes, what this man said. That in Kabiesi's heart, that Miriam is a goner already. But Miriam keep creeping in. Miriam keep bringing herself in. That he doesn't know what she have done, no. But one thing he want to assure is that whoever have done that thing for her, that the person will buy on a kum kum. Hey. They were not telling the madman that he's taking it personal. I should calm down. No? The madman said he is going to take everything personal. That anybody that think is taking it personal, that the person have not seen anything, that he is going to continue to take it personal. That everything that concerns Naomi and Omi, that him will take it personal. Anybody that doesn't like it, let the person go and sleep one place. Hey, my brothers, my sister, it's not a small matter. It's not a small shoot bed, mama fly you. At this point there, even Miriam was shaking. Miriam was shivering. Miriam, they don't even know what is wrong with her again. Because it's as if almost today, from police station, from hospital, now she has come to meet a madman. It is well, it is well. My brothers, my sister, this is all I heard. I said I should come and let you guys know what's happening on social media street. See you guys later now. Peace out.